Welcome back, everyone. This is Dan Ugly Doggy coming to you with another episode of This Land Is My Land. So, if you watched the last live stream, you'll have seen something that's pretty rare in my book, and I actually rage quit. Sort of rage quit. I decided to cut my losses and take a break before my losses became even worse. So, in the last episode, I ended up getting knocked down not once, but twice. A few times, actually. To the point where I realized, okay, this is just going to keep happening. My campaign's going to get worse and worse. So I need to move forward. At this point, or I need to take a break before I try to move forward. So at this point, I'm at day 31. I got 5 camps, 47 warriors, 15% of my land back. So let's get back into it. So basically, I just took a deep breath, said, okay, gotta move on, or take a break, and then I can move on, and cut the stream short, kind of abruptly. To be honest with you, I thought about not publishing the episode, but beyond the fact that it's gonna mess up the campaign, the fluidity of the campaign, you guys are gonna miss a little chunk of the campaign, which I don't want. It is part of the game. Rage quits, peaks and valleys, good times and bad times. So even though it's pretty rare, and what I've decided after pondering the events is that the insane mode since the update is actually a little more crazy than it used to be. So I have to rethink my strategy here. And that's pretty much what I'm going to do. So today's stream is going to be a little different. I'm actually going to farm up some social points so I can build up my skills. I'm going to bring in some toys and I am going to melt some snow. So the plan for right now is I'm going to bring in some items. I'm going to start crafting skill points, get up to a couple hundred to 300,000 over the next hour, hour and a half, something like that. Just constantly crafting skill points. And then I'm going to build up some of my skills, and I'm bringing in some toys for my boys. And I'm gonna give them some groceries. I'm gonna get my boys skilled up pretty quick and get myself a nice little war party because I ain't doing this shit by myself. I need to call in the cavalry, and I need my boys to know what they're doing because I don't just want to lose warriors. So we're gonna have a little bit of fun with this campaign, but today is gonna be a grind. So it's not going to be the most exciting live stream in the world, but it is also part of the game. So that's my compromise. I'm going to leave my video up and show my little rage quit, but at the same time, I'm going to make you guys sit through an episode of farming. So let's see where we're at here. I'm still frustrated. I like never get knocked down. So to be knocked down a couple of two, three times in a row is really, really frustrating. Okay, first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to shut down all my farm or all my villages. These guys don't need to do anything. Did I just hear a wolf? Or was that a horse? Alright, I guess that's a horse. I'm gonna sit right in here, chilling. And we're gonna open some mail. The first thing I'm gonna do is grab another bow. Alright, so I got some good toys here. I got some groceries down here. As you can see, this has 4,750. When the time's right, I'm gonna start pulling these groceries out and using them. Actually, I don't need that one. I need this one. So I'm going to bring in some toys. Not too many, just enough to play around with. Nothing too exciting, I suppose. I just want a few options. Got some keys coming in, some good heals, medicine. This is a little more how you should play a campaign, in my opinion. People say it's, little OP and kind of ruins the whole thing. Not to me. I'm totally thinking this is what makes the game the game. Going Rambo and shit, just going ham on the fools. That's where my fun lies. I want to be able to go in and just wipe out a group of people, like, and be blown away that you got away with it. I don't like getting caught in the trap. So I'm going to bring in some bows. And one of these letters has the items I need to farm my social points, or skill points, I mean. If your extra ancestor bows, I have like 600 of those, just from collecting them. Because when you get the Founder's Edition, you get the ancestor bows, and that regenerates every 2 hours. I still haven't really figured out why they do that, but let's see. I don't need that. I don't really think I need the meds. I mean, it's not gonna hurt. Let's see. Now I need to find the items that I want. I want to make sure I brought them, actually. Oh, wait, that's what I need, the Death Camo Elite. Okay. I do need this. All right, so what I'm going to be doing for the next couple of hours here, because it does take time, is I want traps. Big spike traps. Shoot, cost me six. Aha, that's funny. All right. Just shy of what I need. Let's try that again. All right, so that gives me 50. So I need buffalo horn. Did I not? I thought I put this what I needed here. Priority root. Yeah, I did. I didn't bring horns, so. Well, that's a bummer. What do I want to do? Yeah, this is all part of the game. I'm just gonna keep telling myself that. Need rope, but I only have 500 horn. That is not gonna cut it. So, yeah, we're gonna have to go into my feeder campaign. Might as well show you the whole process, right? So, in my opinion, what I'm about to do is what makes this game stand out from others. The possibilities. It opens up a ridiculous amount of possibilities. All right, so I'm in this campaign day 32, but I decide I need stuff. And my best source of stuff happens to be my feeder campaign. And right now what I need is buffalo horn. Huh. It's taking a long time to load this time. That's pretty rare. I'm pretty sure this has something to do with the streaming, because when I wasn't streaming, this never happens. But it seems like every time I stream, every once in a while it takes a little longer, so I don't think that's really representative of the amount of time it took forever. All right, let's see here. We're gonna go ahead, pause. Gonna lower the music down in my headset. What do I want? I want horn. Buffalo. As you can see, I got quite a stack. And I have a reserve. So each one of these are the villages that have collected 200 buffalo horn each. This is a farming campaign. I guess while we're here, I'll go ahead. 120,000. Sounds about right. Wow. All right. So this is a feeder campaign. And basically, what this is, I don't need to pause this, is a campaign that I have full control. All right, as you can see, it's not a dead campaign. They have 6%, 7%, and they're growing. They will actually grow 259 or 49, whatever, 40, whatever that is, percent. But they won't expand past this area. Okay, I've got them all boxed in. Basically, what it is a, I've got my core villages that go out and gather constantly whatever it is I need. The more items that I make them gather, like right now they've already got full camps. But if I were to clear the camps, then all of a sudden this whole area is just going to be busy with my little workers. So what I have here is a pretty much a demilitarized zone. So I have my core, I have a clear zone of no bases, no camps, no villages. And then over here, I let them do whatever they want. So they can expand, but if they try to cross this line at any point, I just wipe them out. What ends up happening is, and this is what I call full control, they go after two different camps. They send groups to attack a camp here, and they send groups to attack a camp up here. Those are the two camps that they ever attack. They don't send patrols through, they don't send any gatherers out. They don't send anything else except for these two attacks. As long as I don't kill the town. I have a town down here, and if I wipe out the town will flip up here. Somewhere in like this region. If I kill that town, the town is going to come down here and flip again. And it looks like I'm losing warriors somewhere as we speak. 53. What is that? He's got a lot of dudes on him. So each one of these are patrols, All right, this guy, oh, this is 53. This is one of the attacks. So this is a group sent from whatever camp to come and attack this particular village. So they actually made it to the village, which is pretty rare, and they're doing a really good job, which is pretty rare too. I'm just not winning right now. This game is just kicking my butt. So anyways, what's happening here is these are patrols, and they've already wiped out a couple of groups. This is getting irritating to watch for a second. But these are groups of 15 of my warriors on horseback. These are all my patrols over here on the side. And as you can see, these bottom ones here are all 15. And you can see these ones with the little red dots are the guys in this fight, which is really not going well for me. Man, I didn't want to sit here and do this. Yeah, of course. For some reason, you suck. That is painful to watch. What do we got? 15, 7, 6. Come on.38, 60, and 54. Good enough for me. And it's, of course, it was. I knew it was wasting my time. Damn it. Oh, they took quite a beating. So, okay. That being said, as you can see here, one of these patrols has a whole bunch of items. They've already beaten one of the city patrols. One of my patrols beat theirs, and now they're holding the items and they're running around with these items. And what you would do is find these guys on the list. Let's see if I can find one. There you go. So I go through my list, and these are what all my warriors are holding. But I'll come across this guy, and this guy obviously hit a wagon or hit a patrol or something, won the fight, and got those items. All of my patrols are sent. Now I'm going to cancel this patrol. So this means that this patrol, wherever he is going to go to my core village, my number one, which is now overpopulated. So actually, I'm going to pause this for a second because I don't want to get too deep into this. But this is my core village, and I send all patrols from this village. I send any of these villages gets overpopulated, I take that overpopulation and I send it to number one, which is why this is overpopulated right now. Now I'm okay because I have a ton of meat in here. But if I didn't have a ton of meat, after just a minute or two, these four extra warriors would leave, and I don't want that. So I have a ton of meat in there, so I'm fine. But as it gets overpopulated, I send groups of 15 warriors on patrol on foot to wherever I want them. And usually, what I do is have cutoffs from up here. I want them to kind of venture out into no man's zone so that they can run into these fools that come from up here. So I have patrols, as you can see here, that kind of wander out to the outskirts. And usually, they intercept and they just beat them. But every once in a while, like you just saw, they make it to the city or to the village, and as you saw, I lost probably seven or eight guys. But that's okay, I'm gonna gain a whole bunch soon enough, so I'm not really worried about it. But that's the basics of it. So they come, they attack, I gain warriors. One of these villages is gonna get overpopulated. I send that overpopulation to number one. And as it gets overpopulated, then I send out a group of 15. Now, this isn't it overpopulated anymore. This is how I have like 4,500 warriors on this campaign. So all my villages are full, even though they all have lower numbers. That's because they're busy. They're out there gathering, doing stuff for me. I can show you my order list right now. So what each, they all get the same items. I have them all collect the same items at the same time. So this is what they're collecting right now. This is your core, your wood, your sinew, your hunter's bow, and your arrow. These allow you to do anything else in the game. So as long as they have a supply of these, they can get any pelt, any whatever. As you go through the list, right now I'm trying to make a bunch of, now I have way more than I need, but a bunch of treatments for the injury system. And this is how I did that. And you can, as you can see, I can get these 200 of each, probably in the order of like 2 hours, 3 hours, something like that. So they have a war paint. And I'm not even sure if I'm wearing it. I am. So this war paint, which you get in the store, which changes every whatever amount of hours it is. But this, the offerings change, and some of these will say rare. This is a rare war paint. And what it gives me is 150 spyglass, which I never use, 1.4 health, and 200 warrior gathering percent. So that means that my boys gather quicker on top of what they're already doing. Plus, obviously, my skills. Oh, yeah. Here you can see I have 960. I wish I could transfer these skill points, but I'm at 916 right now because all my skills are maxed. So, this is a feeder campaign. So you can just imagine what I can do in this campaign. Yeah, I mean, yeah. And this is how I have a market. This is how I sell my wares. You can see how many items I have. So, feeder campaigns, you gotta love them. All right, so what I'm gonna do here is attach these into a letter. Just make sure that's not. And that's all I want, right? Yeah. Let's try to stay on track here. I've actually got a movie to watch with my girl while this goes, so. The plan here is I'm going to set this up to start farming social points or skill points, and then I'm going to go watch a movie with my girl. That's my plan. So you guys can sit here and watch. Watch the magic. If you're watching this on YouTube later, feel free to skip ahead. All right, let's get out of here. Let's go. I could tell you more about this feeder campaign, and I'll do that later, but right now I've got a plan. I gotta try to stick to my plan. My girl's gonna kick my butt. I'm like 5 minutes, hon. It's been like 10. Oh shit, it's been 25. Yeah, see? I literally told my girl 5 minutes. All right, stick to the plan. Come on, hurry up. Damn. Let's go. All right. So this is what they mean when they talk about all campaigns are connected through social. Not only can you send it to other people, you can just send it to yourself. So like I'm doing, you start a campaign, you think you're going to do one thing, and it leads into another, and it leads into another, and all of a sudden, you've got all these great ideas. You want to have the toys, you know? Because I've got some plans ahead. I'm just gonna have fun with this campaign. I'm gonna kick its butt, and I'm gonna have fun with it. I got some tricks up my sleeve, so this is gonna be more of an interesting campaign for me. And you guys can just see what I do when I get bored. All right, so we're back. And I want to open my letter, get this show on the road. Can't believe I forgot to send this to myself. So I want to go up here. Right, we should be set. Go to traps. And we are golden. So I haven't done the math with the numbers on this. I think this is pretty close to a million, but I forget actually. We'll have to see. I'm not going to do the whole thing. I think that takes like 4 hours. But I do want to take a peek on the market. So another whole aspect, a lot of at least people that I've watched seem to miss out on is the market. The market is awesome. I mean, this is a stupid price. But I mean, look at that, $3. You can have yourself a sharps at any point, even though it's a low quality. But 295 for a beautiful little rifle, you know? Market is a great little place. You don't just have to, if you're worried about OP and the stuff, it's not going to kill the phone, trust me. Because these guns break anyways. Actually, he's offering. That's not a good price. Sometimes you find some really stupid deals. Like I've seen this rifle for sale for, I think it was 100. You know, people are funny. I'll buy that up all day long. All right, nothing too exciting. That's not a bad little deal. Those are actually kind of hard to find. All right, good enough. No more distractions. Let's get on it. All right, so farm and social points. I keep calling it social points, skill points. Each one of these items that you craft gives you a certain amount of skill points. This particular one gives you what I've found to be the most. I could be wrong, but I've been okay with it. It's semi-easy to farm the needed items to craft this in large quantities. And it gives you 50 a piece, so it actually goes pretty quick here. Now you notice down in the chat, which we didn't go into at all, there's certain information, and this is why I enjoy the chat. One, the chat is actually really nice. If you have any questions about the game, you can feel free to jump in there, and almost any time throughout the day, you'll find an individual on there willing to answer the same question that he's answered like a million times, and be happy to do it. I mean, we really want people to be able to find the potential of this game and enjoy it. And I personally want to watch people stream it. I want people that, you know, have really dug into the game and shown some of the possibilities that other people just don't even think about. So we all encourage everybody to learn as much as you can, and the best way to do that is to ask a question. But beyond that, you can actually just sit here and enjoy the conversations. Here you can see what I've sold in my social and what I've bought. So somebody bought one of my keys, which I happened to sell for 50 on the social, and I bought the rifle. You know, it's just something interesting. Every once in a while you glance over and you see something going on in your part of the game. It's kind of cool. So here we are. As you can see, I've done 21 so far, and I'm actually getting 68 skill points per. And you'll notice that up here, the amount is going up. Now I don't really have to interact with this at all. What I can act the unfortunately what I can't do is pause. So theoretically, and I feel I'm safe even at this point because they're not really going to expand aggressively yet. Even though I've been knocked down a couple of times, and each time that happens, And I attacked this this frickin' place. What is it, a farm? Yeah, each time I attack this and I lose, I piss them off. And that's increasing the awareness of everybody on the map. And it's making them get ready. So they're going to start building forts faster. They're going to start building towns up. They're going to start sending out more patrols, more gatherers, more posts, more jail wagons, more everything. Traffic is going to start flowing through, which is going to put my boys in jeopardy. So that's going to mean that if I have gatherers and things coming through all the time, I'm not going to be able to send my warriors out to gather. And if I can't send my warriors out to gather and I don't have a feeder campaign, it's really hard to progress. Now, if I have a feeder campaign, I don't have to send my boys out to do anything. They just sit there and protect. Now, that's actually kind of boring. So I try not to get into that kind of game. But at the same point, it can be kind of fun to be like have camps in between you, sending out people trying to attack your camps, and you kind of learn how to defend those camps. I mean, it's a practice, it's a training. That may not be a campaign you're going to want to keep, but if you do things like that, it'll help you learn. And you pick up strategies and you learn what works, what doesn't, what's a waste of time, what's not. It's actually really cool once you get into the depths of trying to, like, how do I make this village defend itself? Now, I know there's going to be a thing coming out here every so often and they're going to attack it because they run into it. So now I know where my attack's coming from. Now I can sit there and focus and learn how to defend from that attack. And once that attack fails every time, then I've got something to work with. And that's kind of what I do. Sit there and try to dissect the whole interaction. It's, my thing, I guess. But anyways, as you see, I'm now at 68, 68, 68, 68, which has got me at 5,000. Okay, so from here on, for the next hour and a half or so, I am going to be away from the keyboard, and this is just going to run, and you get to watch this number increase, and hopefully, yeah, I don't think I'm going to run out of parts. I suppose I could leave it like this, and we'll see if I become a total gummer and have you guys sitting here with one of these four things being empty. But yeah, it shouldn't happen. So anyways, if you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and unless something happens. Now, I don't have control of this map, so I'm taking a big chance here. And I'm not liking those odds at all. So, this is going to piss my girl off so bad. But these guys need something. Let's do that. Gosh, they only have five. I thought I had more warriors. Wait, what is that? That is number four. Let's send five. So much for equipped group. It always gives them friggin' stun arrows. These are the one guys I don't want to have stun arrows. What do I need? 38. And what is that? 5, so 50. I don't want to spend a bunch of time doing this kind of stuff. Let's just give them that. You take horses? All right, we're going to send them over to kind of help out with this village. That makes me worried about walking away. All right, I guess I got to spend a second doing this. Okay, was that? I mean, it's not really going to take me that long to do this. Least it'll help. And last but not least, and I do have a problem leaving all of this in here. This is not a big enough village to sit there and hold my good stuff. No. I don't think so. Of course, I'm standing in it, but that's another story. Yeah, good enough. Oh, I almost clicked it. All right, back to farming. Okay, that should be good. Post wagon. They go all over the place. Yeah, they don't stick to the road. But this village is in a pretty bad spot. This is not a good fork in the road at all. I'm just, okay, I guess I'm hoping here. I wasn't planning on doing this, so I would have had all my villages right here if I were planning on this. But this is just the way it's going to be. And that's another fun thing about this game is, you may set up the best plans in the world, but sometimes this game is going to change them. It's going to lead you down a different path. So I could have just beat my head against this thing and kept going at it and kept going at it and, made things worse, but I've learned. Just take a deep breath, take a break, come on back and kick its ass, So it's gonna feel good tomorrow. Anyway, all right, I gotta get to my girl. Again, if you're still watching this on YouTube, go ahead and skip forward to where something happens besides this. All right, it'll be like an hour and a half or so. All right. Thank you for watching, guys. I'll be back in a bit. Peace out for now. I'll be back. I'll be back. That's funny. I checked out my stream and I noticed that my little follower bar is covering the scale points. I'm such a noob. Yeah, trust me, guys, I'm not a streamer. How do I get the volume off? Okay, that was fun. Anyways, back at it. Alrighty. Are we having fun yet? So that's been what, about an hour? Maybe an hour and 20 minutes or so? 130,000 skill points, I like it. I'd be able to do something with that. So I enjoyed the movie with my girl. That was fun. Yeah, 5 minutes turned into an hour. For anybody that watched the beginning of this, they'll know what that means. That was funny. And she was all right with it. So anyway, all right. I'm thinking that's pretty close to about what I need. Let's see. Turn down the game volume just a hair. Right, now I gotta decide what I wanna do with these points. And how am I going to move forward on this campaign? Things to think about. And what am I going to do with another, what, 1900 big spike traps? It doesn't look like social's been super active. 9 o'clock. Let's see if anybody wants these. Okay, so I need a game plan here. Think I'm gonna want to make some war parties to come along with me. Okay, good. I never know what's gonna break the cycle for crafting. It looks like I can go through my inventory and kind of come up with a game plan. So what did I bring with me? 300 war bows. The hunter bows are so my villages can kind of get a head start. I'll put like 50 in each one. The ash bows, in case I need to use explosive arrows for something. I brought in kind of like 8 of these heavies just to give to my war parties. These are all mainly for war party fun. Try a couple things out. I'm pretty much gonna arm all my villages with war bows. So I'll end up bringing more war bows in as I need them. I might just have these guys craft them. We'll see. They're not too hard to craft. What did I bring? These are all different medicines I just want to kind of try. Alright. That's pretty much all the good stuff there. Let's see. Now my war party guys are going to be level 1. Chances are they're going to die. If I'm smart, I just give them war bows. That would probably be the best idea. I could give them decent sharps. I've got plenty of them. Things to chew on. All right, for now, I think I want to end this video before I start moving forward because it's already 2.5 hours in. Looks like this post wagon never gets close enough. I'm guessing he goes over here and goes back. I don't know, I haven't been watching. But let's see what we got for skills. What am I going to do with the skill points? I definitely want more stamina. I've been having a hard time with the stamina. And I want to see more of my territory, detect the enemies. I don't care about grab. Leadership for sure. And I'm not overly worried about their weight carrying capacity. Gave myself 133. I'll do these very last. So the question is, what to do, what to do? Hundred thirty-three. You would think 133,000 skill points are gonna go far, but I know from experience they get used to it pretty quick. All right, I'm thinking. Actually, I'm thinking to myself, I should stop this video, start another stream, so I can kind of break it up. Because I don't think anybody's going to really be watching the end of this video. So I may as well start using the skill points in the next one. So at this point, they're at 20%. I'm at 14.7. The red blob's not too bad. Nobody seems to have died. And I still need to go back and get my stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and end the stream here, and I'm going to restart the next stream in like a minute. So I'll be right back.